I entered a giveaway and I won. I unbox everything from the Retro Gamers Podcast giveaway right here and right now. Hey, what's going on, everybody? Leigh Dickey here, comedian, actor, producer, reviewer, and occasional genius. The jury is still out on that last one. Trust me, before we get to this Retro Gamers Podcast giveaway unboxing, I want to ask you to please hit the subscribe button. If this is your first time here, please do comment, like, share, and subscribe. Follow along on social media. All the links are in the description. And let's get to this podcast giveaway unboxing of the Retro Gamers grab bag of goodness. I want to send a quick shout out to Larry and Anthony from the Retro Gamers Podcast for sending this along. I'm thankful to have entered the giveaway and very grateful for them to have spun the wheel, drawn my name, and to have had to basically have all this good stuff. Now, Larry was a guest on the Beats and Speaks podcast a little while ago. I will leave a link to that in the description and in the cards. I will also leave a link to the Retro Gamers podcast in the description and in the cards, so you guys can go check them out as well. But I, again, just want to say thank you to both Larry and Anthony of the Retro Gamers podcast for sending this along. Now that's enough of me blathering, let's get on to the unboxing, shall we? Okay, right here, right now, an unboxing of the Retro Gamers podcast holiday giveaway, because Santa is my homeboy. He's right here, you see what I mean? Right here, right now, on this video. All right, so here we go with this Retro Gamers podcast giveaway unboxing. First, this is actually really cool. This really caught my eye. It is an 8-bit sort of pixelated stocking of Santa Claus. You got the ho-ho and then Santa up here and a nice little design. It kind of looks a bit like the early Nintendo games, which is really, really nice. I'm going to flip this over really quickly. As you can see, there's nothing on the back, but, you know, I mean, pixelated Santa, video game related, obviously, because it's a Retro Gamers podcast, and really cool to have it. I mean, this is probably one of the first things that caught my eye the minute it came through the door, and, you know, really cool to have it. So, a Santa pixelated 8-bit stocking. I'm probably going to use this next year. Well, not even probably. I'm definitely going to use this next year. What am I saying? But there it is, the first thing out of this Retro Gamers podcast giveaway. Next, this Diddy Kong figurine. I don't know much about it other than, like, it's a small figurine. And, you know, I remember Diddy Kong Racing. That was probably one of the best-selling and or favorite Nintendo 64 games. And I do remember the Donkey Kong animated series from the 90s because that was right in my wheelhouse. It's cool to have this Diddy Kong figurine here, and I'm assuming, obviously, as you can see here, it's part of a series of six other figures, and, you know, it's cool that I have this. I mean, I've always loved Donkey Kong and Diddy Kong, so gonna give it a good home here, this Diddy Kong figurine, so really cool. Next, the World of Nintendo Splat Balls. These are from Jack's Pacific. I'm not sure which one is in this sort of packaging, and I should say that everything that came in this giveaway that I got through the front door is going to stay sealed. I don't want to, you know, ruin the integrity of the packaging too much. I want to keep them sealed. I want to preserve them. So these Splat Balls, you know what they remind me of? They remind me of the Blurp Balls from the 1990s when sort of gross-out toys were all the rage. It's actually really cool. Again, Splat Balls from Jack's Pacific. Let's take a look at the back here. And you see that they come in a series of four. Don't know which one this is, but I'm not going to, you know, open the package. I'm going to keep them sealed just because I feel like I should. I feel like I should. Pardon me. Still, another cool little piece here coming in the Retro Gamers podcast giveaway. Now this is cool, a Fox McCloud plush. It says from the World of Nintendo, so I'm wondering if they're from the, you know, Nintendo storefront in New York City. I don't know if either Larry, you know, who's been a past guest on my show, the Beats and Speaks podcast, or his co-host, Anthony, knows, please do let me know. That would be cool to find out. But as you can see here, another piece to this Retro Gamers podcast giveaway, a Fox McCloud plush. And that's honestly really cool. You know what I mean? Who doesn't love Star Fox? I know I played it a bunch on the Nintendo 64, Star Fox 64, and Super Smash Brothers. Because the 90s was sort of like my heyday when it came to gaming. I do know what the original Nintendo is. I do know the Magnavox Odyssey and several Pong machines. But, you know, if you give me anything from like the 90s, I'd probably know what that is. Obviously, the original Nintendo, Sega, Super Nintendo. I know what the Atari Jaguar was and all that stuff. But again, this World of Nintendo, Star Fox, Fox McCloud, plush. Really cool, you know what I mean? And to be fair, everything in this sort of grab bag giveaway really surprised me. I'm actually just really happy to have entered this giveaway and to have had my name drawn. So, Larry, Anthony, if you guys are watching, thank you both very, very much. On to the video games in this Retro Gamers podcast grab bag giveaway extravaganza stocking deal. WCW versus NWO Revenge. I loved this game as a kid, you know, and to be fair, like, I'm a giant wrestling fan, so this is right up my alley. So thank you to both Larry and Anthony for including this in the stocking. That was very, very thoughtful. I'm pretty sure it was just one of those, like, one goes here, and then, you know, one game to me, and then one went to the other winner. I think his name was Kyle. So, you know, this came in my stocking anyway, WCW versus NWO Revenge. I loved this game. I was always a big fan of the Giant, a.k.a. the Big Show. So I always picked him. It's actually quite funny to see Raven, of all people, on the cartridge or on the basically on the cover art for this game, because I mean, I don't know whether or not he was like the biggest star in WCW. I mean, you go to ECW, of course, he was one of their mainstays, and then he was what, Johnny Polo in the WWF back in the day, and also he came to the WWF when ECW and WCW went out of business in the spring of 2001. Actually really cool to have this. I would always play as the Giant or the Big Show when I did have this, you know, when I did rent this game. I never did own it, so it's cool to have it. You know, you see Hollywood Hulk Hogan here, Kevin Nash, and of course WCW's like golden boy, if you will, that wasn't Sting, Goldberg. So thanks again, guys, for including this in the giveaway. Up next, the Die Hard trilogy. Now, I've heard of this. I have never played it. I never did own it back in the day. I have heard of this sort of trilogy of Die Hard games. I'm assuming they are based on the first three movies. Obviously, you had Die Hard from 1988, Die Hard 2, Die Harder, and that was from 1990. And then Die Hard with a Vengeance, which was 1995, I think. Which, surprisingly enough, at least if we're talking those three movies, Die Hard 2 is my favorite. I do enjoy the first Die Hard. Die Hard 3, or Die Hard with a Vengeance, like, meh. Kind of iffy on that one, but cool to have this. I knew it existed. Never did rent it. Never did own it back in the day. It's from Fox Interactive, which is now owned by Disney, so I'm assuming Die Hard technically is now a Disney property. So, I don't know. You think the House of Mouse will Disney-fy Die Hard? Any guesses? Put them in the comments below. I don't know. Cool to have this. And let's move on to the next thing. Next up, we have EA Sports NHL 94 for the Sega Genesis. Now, I've never played this. I did have a Genesis back in the day. I think I might actually still have it. It's probably in the basement somewhere. May have to hook it up just to see if it still works. But it's cool to have NHL 94. Now, I personally, the first NHL sort of centric game that I played was NHL 96 for the Super Nintendo,
because that's the first thing I had, or one of the first systems I had anyway. It's cool to have this. It says up at the top here, $6.99. I'm honestly hoping that, I think I got this from Anthony because he's the one that shipped it to me. I'm hoping that this isn't his original copy. So, Anthony, if you bought this back from the store you sold it to, kudos. But, you know, the fact that somebody paid $6.99 for it, very cool. I mean, it's cool to have this. And if I have my Genesis and I can dig it out, I'll hook it up and pop this in. Let's turn the case over just to see what the back looks like. So here's the back of the NHL 94 case, and you see the Mighty Ducks of Anaheim are front and center, and that probably would have been the team that I would have picked, because that's the team that I picked in NHL 96 a lot, just because of the popularity of the Mighty Ducks franchise. But you see the 16-bit greatness. The siren is going to wail, and apparently over 25 new features in NHL, or yeah, in NHL 94. Four-way play, penalty shots, which honestly one of my favorites, the penalty shots and the shootouts, is other than, you know, playing actual, say, like season mode or exhibition games, like I love playing, you know, the penalty shots and the shootouts and stuff like that. So you get the ability to have one-timers, which is really cool. Battery backup, music and animations. I mean, this was 1994, so it was cutting edge, apparently. So let me see if I can just focus and tilt my camera here a little bit. But, yeah, I mean, this was typical, like, NHL for early to mid-90s. And it was top seller, because they're still making them to this day. I think, what are they up to now? NHL 21? Something like that, as far as I know. Cool to have it. Thanks again, guys. Last and certainly not least, Track and Field, or is that Track and Field 2 for the Nintendo Entertainment System, or the original Nintendo, if you will. Now, I'm not going to, you know, complain about the condition of the cartridge. Not even sure how old this thing is. It's probably obviously easily more than 30 years old, maybe even closer to 35. But I found it funny, because let's just flip the cartridge over here as I get my fingers out of the way. Do not store in extreme temperatures. Do not immerse in water. Do not clean with benzene, thinner, alcohol, or other such solvents. Copyright 1985, Nintendo. So yes, it's, well, 36 years old this year. Do not store in extreme temperatures. So basically, don't take this thing to the Arctic Circle. Again, that's the last of it here for this Retro Gamers Podcast giveaway. Track and Field, or Track and Field 2. I can't even tell whether or not that is a Roman numeral. It's by Konami. Classic on the original Nintendo, or the Nintendo Entertainment System, or NES if you prefer. All right, so there you have it. My unboxing of the Retro Gamers Podcast holiday giveaway grab bag of goodies. I want to send a thank you once again to Larry and Anthony of the Retro Gamers Podcast for A, drawing my name. I'm thankful that I entered, by the way, because I didn't think I would win. So I'm thankful for them for drawing my name and sending this along. I hope you guys enjoyed the video and the unboxing. If you're listening to this on audio, please subscribe to both Yo Nostalgia and the Beats and Speaks podcast. This will be up there as well. You can subscribe to the Retro Gamers Podcast and follow them along on social media. I will leave all those links in the description. Please visit my official website, LeighTDickey.com. Subscribe here on YouTube to Leigh Dickey TV. But that's it. This wraps it up. I've been Leigh Dickey. This wraps up another episode on Leigh Dickey TV. Thank you all for watching. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe, and we will see you next time. Santa, say goodbye. Okay, fine. Don't say anything at all. All right, guys, I'm Leigh Dickey, and I'm signing off. We'll see you next time. Peace.
Ant, we're here to announce...
We are here to announce the winners of the Retro Gamers Podcast Holiday Giveaway, or whatever the hell we called this thing. I don't even remember. It was some type of contest, but we are giving away these two really cool little 8-bit ho-ho-ho stockings.
It's, yes.
And I just want to say we're not calling anybody names. It's actually Christmas related. Ho, ho, ho.
What'd you say? The retro tro tro or something?
The retro tro tro. Yeah, yeah, whatever. You're not allowed to make up stuff. We talked about this. So anyway, so we've got two stockings and they're loaded with a few little, you know, some little retro goodies. Maybe there's a game or two in here. I don't know.
Wait, what?
You'll find out.
You didn't tell me what's in them.
I didn't tell me what's in them.
Fair enough.
So the bottom line is, like, there's some, you know, there's some cool stuff in there, all game related, and these will obviously get to whoever wins these after the holidays, but it'll still be the holiday season, and we're hoping you, whoever wins these, enjoys what's in them, and hopefully, depending on what you get, we'll be able to play what's in them.
So I was going to say real quick before we get to the winners, and yes, I've set it up. There will be a graphic. You will be able to see the winners. So. It's going to be hard to get together.
I don't trust you.
No, neither do I. All right. Can we, do you want to get right into it? Unless you have anything that happened or came up or.
What? Oh,
have you beaten anything already?
Since we dropped our episode?
Yeah.
No,
12 hours ago?
Nothing has happened except my, you know, continuing descent into madness.
There you go. I like it.
That just happens.
Delete. All right. So, basically, what we have again is, and thank you everyone who signed up and who joined, signed up, who just entered. And so we have everyone's name on the big wheel of names. And I'm going to spin this around. So you should probably still see Anthony, but then you're going to see the screen. Okay, here's what we're going to do.
Spin it on Instagram and then flip your phone over and show it on Facebook. Let's just move on.
Okay. All right, well, any event, you know,
hello,
a winner's a winner.
Mega Games just joined, so hello, Mega Games.
All right, here we go. All right, so for the folks at Instagram, you're going to get to see this. It's not going to go quick enough for Facebook, but I'm going to announce the winners anyway. So, again, thank you, everyone who participated. I have everyone's name in here, and we're going to do two spins, one winner each. All right, here we go. So for the second winner, ladies and gentlemen, here we go. You should hear the music in my head is fantastic.
Oh, jeez. Nobody wants to hear the music in your head because last time I checked, it was all Spice Girls.
Yes, I have no problem. Oh, LeighTDickey.com.
Oh, wow. Leigh, congratulations. Leigh. If you're still watching at this point.
What? So the winners, Kyle and Leigh. Congratulations. Okay.
Let's go back to me.
Congratulations. Oh, Leigh, we got to pay international for you. All right.
So Leigh and Kyle, thank you very much for entering and for winning the holiday Christmas stockings. We'll be contacting you to get your information so I can mail those over to you. And then for everybody else who entered, thank you so much for entering. Yes. And just keep an eye out for our next contest. We'll have one eventually. Right?
And by then, I'm going to have a physical giant wheel where we could put the names on it. I might know someone who has one. And just knock it all out. I'll just knock this wall down. It'll be just a giant wheel.
And that'll be the last time I'm ever on the show.
All right, folks. Well, with that, again, congratulations, Kyle. Congratulations, Leigh. Anthony, maybe off camera, you can tell me what's actually in the stockings because I'm quite curious what's in them.
You know what? I'm kind of curious, too. I don't remember what I put in there.